Welcome to the Finance Committee meeting of February 14th. First item on the agenda is the minutes from last week's meeting.
Make a motion, we approve them.
Motion?
Second.
Second. Any discussion? Looked good to me. Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? It's unanimous. The first thing that I thought we would do tonight was to talk about revenues. So in front of you somewhere should be something that looks like a piece that looks like this. Is that right? Debt and
tax levy calculation.
Tax levy calculation.
I thought you said.
And debt exclusion, the items that make up the debt exclusion are listed on the lower part of the page. And those are subject, at least a little bit, to change, in particular the school roof. Mm-hmm. At this point, we don't know what the... So is that an estimate for interest payment, which at this point is all we are likely to have?
Are you talking ahead? Mm-hmm.
And
yeah, that's the basically what we're paying for 6 months of the loan that we have right now. If we were to renew that, we're just saying, okay, it could be about the same number, right?
For 6 months. So we would need to double that for a year. Right?
Maybe.
Presumably.
Sooner or later, we've got to pay the interest.
Yeah. Yeah. Someplace along the way, we're going to, you know, it would just... We know what the garage is.
It's due in April, so if we did another 6 months, that'd be October. And then if we went out to a permanent situation, or I don't know if we're going to just keep on renewing it. And if so, then it would be probably a year. So I don't think we'd pay two interests next year. We'd probably...
You would
in
have
April,
to
I'd probably renew it for a year, right? Because come fall,
but,
I don't know
but
when
the interest will be double what it would be for 6 months.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's hard to say.
So
it is, yeah.
But before town meeting, we...
The last time I borrowed it was like, what was that, $3,000, and this time it's $5,700. So it all depends on the market and the bids and if it's attractive or not, or timing, or who knows.
Okay.
Yeah.
But we'll get it.
So we have a number as a place marker at least to at least start start the conversation.
Right. Okay. The next one, we've got page 1 of 2. And if you want to take a look at the cherry sheet breakdown, and I'm going to let Brenda talk about that. She put it together.
This is the first cherry sheet estimates. I believe that's the governor's, right, Wendy? So that's where those numbers came from. And so we have what comes directly into the town and then what gets charged directly against the town. So the numbers that you don't see in here are numbers that go directly to the school that we don't see. School choice, I guess that's the only one that goes directly to the school would be school choice, which just as a side note was quite a bit lower this year than it was in past years. I think it was 500 and some thousand. Is that right?
No.
$200,000.
It was 190.
700,000 or something.
So it was just under 700,000, and it's just under, I believe, 500,000 for this coming year.
The other number that you won't see in here is a small number that comes from state aid for library, correct? Yeah.
And any questions on the state aid? Because
I have the final number.
Final number usually doesn't come through until June or July.
Until the budget, state budget is passed.
So we'll work with this number?
Well, we work with this number to start with, and then the next time, it'll get changed when the House takes it up. I think they usually take it up first.
Yep.
So they'll come out with a cherry sheet figure, and when they're finished with it, the Senate gets it, and they come out with a number, and we use that if we've made it to, if we have, as long as we haven't already made it to town meeting. So we take the most recent one, we go to town meeting.
We can get a sense from our legislators about where things are going.
It's an estimate. It's not.
Leave us alone. Okay.
The governor's pretty
conservative.
Well, he's conservative, but he's also very pro-local government. He was a selectman. So I think he's more generous than previous governors have been. So I don't think the numbers will be far off. That's just my
if you,
anecdotal information.
Well, and actually, if you think about last year, they didn't change very much last year between the beginning and the end either. Yeah.
I think a lot of it has to do with state revenues. You know, we'll have to see what happens.
Yeah. The state cherry sheet revenues, the net effect of cherry sheet revenues really has not changed significantly since 2010, and maybe before. It's in the $1.5 million range. But that's what we got. And local receipts.
It does show the school choice number.
There you go.
166.
That's our charge. So the income on school choice goes directly to the school.
Okay.
The charge for school choice comes out of our tax money.
Okay.
Yeah.
Or it comes out of the
out of the general fund.
Yeah, whatever the revenues are to the town.
So it's less this year.
The overlay figures, the assessors are going to, will likely be here later this evening, and we can talk with them about the overlay figures.
And I don't know that they can give us a definite on what they'd be doing.
We can try.
But they might give us a ballpark that might be better than what I threw on there of $120,000. Mm. I just put that on there because if you look at the history of the last 5 years, it's could be generally about that.
Yeah, it's typically what we've used. Local receipts.
Those are the numbers that we talked about earlier in a finance committee meeting, mm-hmm. Earlier in the, I don't know if it was last fall or maybe back in January but we did go over those numbers earlier. Those are the numbers I plugged into this spreadsheet just to have something in there to go by. Nothing earth-shattering.
Questions on that one? Again, those are, I don't know what you'd call it, 20, 25% below what the actuals are. But we won't get the actuals until a year and a half from now. So,
mm-hmm. So these are conservative by 20 and 25%.
Yes. Yeah. Okay.
So then that brings us to the backside, which there isn't a lot that's plugged in here for right now, but we have, if you remember right, we have a premium on that garage bond that has to be amortized over the life of the bond as an offset to the expense. So that's the $8,228. And then the other three numbers are just a first quick estimate to put something in there for indirect costs. Those indirect costs will be recalculated once we have the salaries set for the selectman's office, the treasurer's office, mine, so on and so forth, so that we know what we can be applying towards that percentage that was set back by the administrators back in, I don't know, was that January of 16 that was set? I can't remember for sure.
If the only thing that I'd point out is South County EMS, the $116,000 for FY17, that really was a 2-year figure. So that's why
Correct.
There's such a difference between the FY 2018 and the 2017. That was both the FY
16 and 17.
16 and 17, only one.
And the only other funding source that's noted on here right now so far is the Dickinson Library Trust money. That's an interest figure that is used by the library and then the Frontier Library.
And workers' comp fund?
I don't believe there's anything left in that fund.
$35.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Insurance indemnification?
I believe that's gone too, or at least it's
low.
Okay. Yep.
And the municipal building fund, that's what we have available in there.
I believe,
so whether we use that or not.
I believe right now there's about 48,000 something in that account.
Okay. All right.
Where would sale of town-owned property show up?
That doesn't show up anywhere. That goes into a fund that's set aside specifically for projects that require, or let's say, capital projects that that we can take out a bond on. There's some specific rules on what we can use that money for, so it's set aside.
DOR rules.
Yes. Correct. DOR rules.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have rules yet.
But it is something that there are things that we could use it for if we got to that point.
Yes.
And where's it tracked? Do we ever know how much money we have in that account?
In what?
How do we track that? Do we get an accounting of it?
You do on a monthly basis. I give you with all the other funds.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. It's in that list.
All right. Thank you.
Are we ready to move on, or do you have more questions?
Any questions?
No.
Okay. So then, you can see the sewer revenue. I had no idea what to put in there for sure, because I know that hasn't been set yet. So I put in 700,000 just as a marker, just to start somewhere. I believe Kevin is waiting for some direction on finishing up his budget on that.
Questions?
So this is revenue anticipated not from the last billing?
Correct. That would be for fiscal 18.
That would have been.
Yep. And usually that's set based on what the expenses are going to be for fiscal 18, so the expenses haven't been set because I think there's some question yet on how we're going to proceed.
So actually, when we collect the money, we're paying for something in the past?
No.
No, kind of.
The other way around?
Present, right, present. Right at the time. So fiscal 18 budget, budgeted expenses are going to be what you're going to plan on receiving in revenues. For fiscal 18.
Yep,
so they're a direct offset of each other.
Okay.
So the figure you see in here for FY 2018 revenues, those are approximately equal to the budget amount for FY 2018. Again, that part's up to the.
It would do us an increase, significant increase in sewer bills.
Fees.
There was, which is reflected. If you look at FY 16 versus FY 17, you see the jump.
Yep.
So you see that there was about $150,000 difference between those 2 years. I can't presume to know what is expected for fiscal 18.
We set the rate, the sewer rate in the fall.
That's October. Yeah. Or something. That's what they do last year.
And anything that isn't expended stays in the sewer reserve fund.
Yes.
Correct.
Right.
So I'm not sure what the balance of that fund is right now.
I went to that in the monthly report.
We can get that next time.
Well, I think at the end of the fiscal year, it was like, did you say 340,000? That's the number I have in my head, is like 340,000, but
that's what we had heard, approximately 340.
Yeah, that's what I'm remembering, but my memory isn't always the best.
Any other questions?
Okay. And then down there at the bottom, free cash. You know, I can't presume again to know how we're going to proceed with this fiscal year yet, so I just threw in that we would keep 500,000 back. Whether, you know, I'm assuming some of that might be used for various
someplace, yeah.
Yeah, various things that like stabilization maybe, or, you know.
Right. This. And we definitely need to reserve some. So going forward, we don't shortchange ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
With that.
Right. So it's a starting point.
All right. Sewer reserve fund on this someplace?
It is, if you look at 610.
Okay.
It's your fund, 610.
Yeah, wastewater treatment plant fund. So as of 6/30/2017, according to this, there was 544,000 in it.
I think.
Or is that, should that be 131.17? Ending balance does say 600 or.
End of January, is that what you're looking at?
543 is the balance here.
It could be. We've taken in some good revenues for that this year.
Okay, so that should be the ending balance for 131.
Okay.
The end of January.
We're due January 6th, so
okay.
That's probably
going to
be it.
Sure. Okay.
Now what I'm looking for is my list of the budgets that we're going to take up tonight.
You need mine?
I don't know. Yeah. I had a list here someplace, so let me just do a quick look through here.
610.
Do you have it maybe with the individual budgets?
No, remember what that.
Can we talk about this stuff?
Yeah, more or less.
Yep.
That's what you had given me.
Oh, no. No. This is the new one.
I'd be smart to take all your binders back every time and refill them, wouldn't it? Wouldn't it? Okay.
No. Now, this one I had just a few minutes ago before I came here. This one, I think. Okay, first one, 145,5410, if we just take them in numerical order, treasurer collector expenses. Were you prepared to deal with that one? I don't know if I mentioned that to you.
I have all mine done, so
okay.
As best I can at this point. 145,5410, is that recent?
Yep.
Yep. I have it in here at 27,975.
And that went down because of the fact that you don't have to have a national election. Or major election.
Well, this is the treasurer collector, so the elections aren't on here. I don't have the GASB 45 expense. I did prepare a detail, which I feel like this is my third year in this position, so I feel like each year I own it a little more based on what I've spent and what I haven't spent and that kind of thing. I took out a couple things. I've never gone to the MMA conference. I took that out. We've been
I've been putting tax title expenses on the recap sheet, set it in the budget. That's happened a year or two, so I'm confident. So I cut my tax title budget on this side a little more significantly. The recap sheet isn't done until the fall, and I'm always afraid that at some point something's going to fall through with the funding that way, and then my budget's already set. So I'm afraid to get rid of it completely. But each year I get a little braver. So some of the tax titles on the recap sheet and some of my expenses I cut out, like the MMA conference. Some of the things that my lease on the postage machine is a little less this year. And some of the things that are more expensive than the last two or three years is got to do with postage and Harper's payroll with the ACA. We have to do all those 1095 forms, so that runs another $1,000, $1,200 over the last couple of years.
Which
but if that
forms?
Goes away, then that'd be great.
1095s.
What are
1095s?
For people with health insurance, we're required to report and send them. Right. Almost looks like a 1099, but it's it's anybody who's covered
the
under the
insurance
health
insurance form. They're required to have it through your state
or
taxes.
Tax.
Yeah.
Oh.
So we do that through the payroll service. Mm-hmm. And they produce the forms after we enter in all the health insurance stuff. So anyway, I'm just saying that's a $1,000, $1,200 expense this year and last year. So that's an up, couple downs. In the end, I'm going to go with 28.
Bruce?
Payroll expenses. I understand Skims has a new reporting. Is it working out or not working?
A new payroll
report?
We haven't seen it in action yet. So
you not.
No, I've heard about it. I haven't seen
I've
it.
I've heard about it for a long time.
Yeah, no, I don't know.
I guess I'm too blind.
I also used, you know, what I have spent over the last couple of years just as a guide.
I was just curious.
No, I don't know.
Supposedly it was software to simplify everything.
Yes.
That's what I understand.
Right.
And we're going to try, once I see it or whatever, we're going to try and integrate it if it's possible with Harper's. I really don't know what to expect. I haven't seen it. Or
I'll just mention this because this came up with Joe Markarian the other day. Mm-hmm. He said he has seen it. He's the person who used to work for Department of Revenue, who's now consultant with FERCOG. And he is, through Sunderland, requested that he do a study of South County EMS, and he did mention in a meeting with Brenda and I that he has looked at that software and he thought it was worth the expense, and it's going to be useful, and it is complementary, it is interactive with your software.
With Harper's.
Yeah. Oh, it's with
from
the payroll.
From what we understand,
right,
but until we see it.
Yeah, I agree.
I thought you would find it. Okay.
Always
yeah,
bugs.
No.
Okay, any questions? Are you ready to vote?
I'm ready to
this?
Vote.
Okay.
Make a motion. We accept the treasurer collector expense,
$27,975. Second.
It's moved, seconded. Any further discussion? All right. All those in favor, $27,975?
Aye.
Aye.
You guys are going to be happy with me this year. I am. I shaved it down. I hope I'm not shooting myself in the foot. But
that's why we have the reserve fund.
Again, this is my third year, so I'm getting a little more comfortable with what's been in the expense before. So are you moving on to the town clerk expense?
I'm looking here. Town clerk expense, correct.
Okay. This one, as Mr. Pachorek said, is going to see a dip because we really will only have, hopefully, the town election next year in the fiscal 18. So I cut that down. I don't know, let's see, any other, there wasn't really anything else in this particular, this is mostly postage and forms and bylaw updates. There's really not any wiggle room in any of this stuff. I did, because there are no elections next year, I proposed a new voting machine. I talked to Capital. I thought it was a good year to do it. The new machines have been on the market for a few years. Ours is 13 plus years old. And at that point, I thought it would fit in my budget, and so it did, and I still am under budget. If I were to buy a $7,000 voting machine, my budget would still be only $20,231.
The question I have is, should that be part of a capital?
Well, I went before capital, and I don't know.
When you think about what Scanlon's office is going to do with it, with the audit, we don't capitalize anything until it becomes $10,000. Mm-hmm. So as far as I'm concerned, I think it's just fine here in this budget.
It's already gone through capital anyways with an approval.
But it's, yeah.
The request.
But if it's not 10,000.
That I understand. But still.
The life of it, you're thinking, or?
Well, I think part of that was.
No, it's just, it does have that long life.
Right.
Relatively speaking.
Correct.
It's one of those issues that pops up.
Yeah.
It just tends to throw the number off. This year it doesn't look bad because you had an $8,000 deduction someplace.
Elections.
Right.
The lack of it, and that's exactly why I thought it would fit nicely in this year. So
I think when it comes to capital requests, the one of the advantages to putting it through as a capital request is that if she didn't get the voting machine purchased this year and it carries over into next year, a capital request can be a continuing appropriation and she could use it next year. But I don't see that happening. I see her moving on it pretty quickly and getting it done. So
it's a purchase. It's not rental.
Yeah.
But you can't make this purchase until after town meeting.
July 1st.
I'm not sure.
That's okay.
Can you spend after town meeting?
We don't have an election anyway until May, so it'll give me all the fall to get it ordered and approved through the state and the selectmen and whatever other procedures.
Is there any maintenance fees to it?
There is on the current one, and there will be on that one. And they will give me something for this as a trade-in. Okay. So
the question is, should we trade it in?
Well,
we keep it as a backup?
The thing is, you'd have to then program two sets of cards, which are relatively expensive. That's the biggest expense in an election is programming the cards, along with the election workers. So you really have to declare with the state what you're using for a voting machine. I don't know that you could declare two different ones. I don't know. So.
Do one have the right answer?
What's so, that?
Whichever one had the right answer.
So there's no way of actually having a backup.
No,
yeah.
You can buy two machines.
Right, if you have two of the same machine, yeah.
So
yeah. And it's really not the machine. It's probably going to be the card. And you do have two cards. So you have a card and a backup card. So.
And I had one time when I needed help because the machine didn't work, and they were here within half an hour. And they stayed with me all day. So.
Mm-hmm.
Was that good or bad?
That was good.
Well.
But the bottom line is, I think we're better off to say get rid of the old one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Just keep the one machine and.
Okay.
That machine's old.
It is.
Yeah, it's over 13 years old. Yeah.
I thought it was yesterday that we bought it.
What?
She said it was 13 years old. I remember when that was a big deal when we were buying it. But to me, it seemed like yesterday.
Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah, it does.
Okay.
Make a motion. We accept this budget at $20,231.
Seconded.
It's moved. Seconded. Any further questions?
Nope.
Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous.
I thought you'd like these.
Well, right.
The only question I had on this, and I decided not to ask.
I'm going to pop one in at the end, though, Bruce. No.
Barbara, the only question I had on this, and I decided not to ask.
Oh, go ahead.
$3,741. Aren't you cutting that awfully close there? What's the word?
I know, right? I don't know. I suppose I could have rounded it around. Yeah. I don't know. I added up my previous expenses.
Okay. I waited until we voted before I asked the question.
Here it is.
Let's see.
That's funny. I don't know. I may need it.
So.
It might be out of order.
I think the next one that we were going to do was general insurance.
Oh, okay.
196-5400, do you have that?
Group insurance?
Is that yours?
No, I don't have general insurance.
Okay, forget it then.
Yeah, I was going to say that would be Wendy.
Okay, so these are the good ones. Maturing debt, 710-5900.
Okay. Maturing debt, I don't know, my number's not on here. It says question, I got it.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
But going by numbers, it wasn't there. Okay, so we have, do you have copies of what I'm looking at, right?
I believe so.
I need to read that to you. Yeah, okay. So the only thing, again, we, you know, I don't know what to anticipate for the roof. I don't have anything in there. It's going to be in temporary borrowing or, I don't know.
Yeah, my guess is that we really don't, unless unless we had a bond payment due next April or something like that.
Right. It won't go in there, yeah.
That's, so if we do something, then we'll worry about it then.
Yeah, the band that I have right now is maturing April 11th for $1.5 million. So I'm inclined just to roll that over for a year or, mm-hmm. you know. I don't know.
And pay it off when we bond.
Yes.
Yeah, nobody, I mean, there's no rule that you have to bond as soon as you have a figure, right?
You can actually, we could continue the ban for 10 years now under the new Municipal Modernization Act. So
well,
we could just keep doing that.
You may want to look at that.
Yes, because bonding is very expensive.
Well, that's the point.
Yeah.
So if we can do temporary.
Off the top of my head, that would be my recommendation, especially based on the project sounding like it's coming in lower than we thought it was going to initially. So,
and we also have $200,000 into it that we had had before the project started. So,
yeah.
And we also have the gifts from the schools too.
Yes.
Correct.
And is that a 10-year?
I'm not sure what that was.
I believe those are all 10-year.
Yeah. So
I don't think we have final bills in yet, and then once all that comes in, then we're going to have the audit, and then I don't think we're going to know until the end of the calendar year, probably.
No, my point was,
yeah,
that,
yeah,
doing it.
No, definitely.
Unless it's
something worth considering to do it for 10 years.
Just keep rolling it over, yeah.
Keep
for
rolling
notes.
It over.
That's what it's looking like to
we
me.
We may get hit down the road with higher interest rates, but we may not.
It's still going to be less than bonding.
Still yes. less than bonding. Yeah, yeah exactly. So, I mean, these are set in stone numbers that we have to pay next year. So,
make a motion
really
to accept maturing debt for $340,000.
Go ahead.
The Oxford loan. If we sell the property, would we use the proceeds to reduce the debt?
For the Oxford, we have to.
Yeah, we yes. have to.
So, is the $95,000?
What we owe?
Is that $95,000? How much are we receiving for the sale of property? Do we know?
I don't know.
We
any numbers I've heard were a fraction of what we owe.
I understand.
Yes. Yeah.
Do we don't have a purchase and sale agreement?
It's been the works forever.
I prodded yesterday the lawyers and company. Mm-hmm. Okay. Called and left emails.
Okay. So it won't change drastically.
No, I did bring my schedule of payments, though, so that I'll give you an idea of our principal balances.
Okay.
Those are the two loans.
Okay, maturing debt, $340,000, and that one we'll probably have to revisit.
If we do the headworks, that's the other thing. Is Kevin proposing to do the headworks?
I don't know that it would. I mean, it would have to move awful quick to get it in that fiscal year as
yeah.
a payment, probably.
I think
I don't
you're
know.
Right.
Maybe an interest payment might be due.
Okay. Do we have a motion?
So move.
Second?
Second.
Move, seconded, maturing debt, $340,000. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous. Let's see.
Interest on maturing debt.
Interest on maturing debt.
So as we were discussing, you know, maybe, well, actually, the interest, that 5,700 should be on interest on temporary loans, really, right? The 5,700?
I think where we have it is okay.
Okay.
Because it's excluded debt, I'm okay with that.
Okay, okay. So we might, maybe as we're discussing earlier, maybe that should be higher, or just leave it at that, 5,700, or? That would be the only thing to consider changing.
We can worry about where it is later.
Yeah.
Or not. If we have to do it, you know, at town meeting floor, move the stuff around or something.
Yeah, okay. Okay, the other two are scheduled interest payments, so.
Make a motion, we approve this for interest on maturing debt for $181,896.
Okay, we had a motion, do we have a second?
A second.
Moved, seconded. Any further questions? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous?
Yes.
Interest on temporary loans?
Yeah, we've always had that $5,000 in there. We've used it, you know, in times where we've had to pay interest on abatements or, you know, I did take a short note there for whatever. So.
That's a good conservative approach. We should keep that the same.
That's been in there for
years.
Yep. Yep.
Make a motion, we approve this for $5,000.
Seconded.
Any questions on it? We have a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Give me a second here.
FCOG.
Now we get all the bad news. We had all the good news first. Now we got all the bad news.
Well, FERCOG assessment.
FERCOG assessment is a
figure that's been given to us by FERCOG at this point, so I can't see that's going to change.
It's an invoice.
Yeah.
Yep.
It's an invoice going ahead.
Yeah, they actually factor history and they roll in. They've got a big complicated calculation, but yes. They tell us what our assessment's going to be as of July 1st.
Yeah, which one are you on, Skip? Are you on the actual FERCOG assessment, the core assessment?
830-5400.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
He's actually referring to...
why am I home? My numbers are not there.
Yeah.
And that one's a little different, I think, than... Did you... Although the one that I've got says 44,693.
That's correct.
That's the figure that we're...
Yep.
Yes.
Make a motion, we approve that.
I'll second.
Okay, all those in... any further questions on this one?
No.
Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? I think the next one is Franklin County Regional Retirement.
Okay, that's what I was the one I thought you were talking about. This too is invoiced to us.
So this one is invoiced.
With the discount for paying ahead, is that?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, we'll pay the whole thing in one payment on July 1st to appreciate a discount. So this is the discounted amount.
No, that's...
So the discounted amount is 536,211.
Yes.
Okay. South County EMS, South County Senior Center and Wastewater Treatment Plant, how good are those figures?
They're excellent.
So those are the figures that they're going
to
live with.
Yes, I actually gave it to Zach. So he...
Okay.
This is the one number that we don't have to guess at.
Okay.
We figure out what the assessment is, which is 20 point something, 27.
20.27%.
Yeah. So we basically take the calendar year payroll.
What's that percentage again?
20.27.
20.27%.
Yep, of your...
Based on payroll.
Payroll, yeah. Yeah.
So on this one, we vote the $421,000, because the others are going to be picked up in the South County Senior Center, the wastewater treatment plant, and SCAMS?
Correct.
So I make a motion, we approve $421,044.
Before we vote on this one, you're still on the board?
Yeah.
Someplace along the way, could the rationale for a 20% assessment, and I'm not sure you're the one that should be answering the question, but I'll give it to you since you're on the board.
The 20% actually keeps us on a schedule to be free of our liability within
32.
30 months.
2033?
30,
yeah.
33?
Is it 30, I thought it was 32, but.
Yeah, something in that range.
33. And that's what they figured. I mean, they've had all of their audits done and everything, and they did their, what do they call it?
Actuarial.
Hmm?
Actuarial?
Yeah. And that's where they come out, so that's what the 20% is.
And nobody's screaming at them any worse than we are right now?
No.
No?
Because between the people that have retired and the ones that are on the disabled ones are the ones that are really pushing up most of the people's percentage, because they have to take them out so much earlier. I mean.
And they have for so much longer.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And it's at the 72%.
Is 72? That
the disabled? I think so.
It's pretty high.
Yeah.
So that's really what, I think that's what hit like Orange, and I know it hit us, and it hit, I'm not sure if Montague got hit hard, but Montague has their own, but I know that that's one of the issues. So you can't help it. It's good it's there for our employees. I love it.
Me too.
Board, or retirement, or which?
Retirement.
Yeah, I suppose if make it 100%, what do I care?
No, you're true,
it's just that when we get the tax bills, we do end up paying. Okay.
We don't get $120,000. Second.
So, did we have a motion?
Yes.
Yes.
Second?
I'll second.
All right. All of those in favor? And we're voting $421,044.
Correct.
Okay.
Aye.
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 Yeah. I just wonder if that, is that the, Brenda, is that the, from an accounting standpoint, is that the one that we should be voting, or should we be voting a 536-211?
No, we should be voting the 421-044.
Okay.
And so,
because that's,
we will be voting
that's
the 78, the 6, and the 30 on town meeting floor at some point in time.
Right, because those will be in those budgets, budget, not in the general fund budget.
Okay.
Correct.
Okay, so let me do it again. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Unanimous? Okay. Workers' compensation.
Yeah, they will when I put back into the spreadsheet.
Okay.
What did you want to?
Workers' comp.
Oh, workers' comp. Okay.
Make a motion. We approve $52,238.
Well, let's get an explanation on it first, since it's up.
Trying to help you right through this.
He's right.
He's right.
Yeah.
He's right.
When
you make the motion.
That's right. You make a motion, somebody seconds it, and then you have your discussion.
Yeah.
Further discussion is what I usually do.
So, I got to keep pushing this guy along.
I know. I'm slow.
And besides, somebody's waiting in the other room to go out for Valentine's Day.
Well, all right.
So we got to rush through this thing. Got to be sensitive to the requirements here.
No.
Yeah, we do.
But we're not taking up that budget.
This is when I have upside down.
We're going to take up that budget tonight. Rec department.
Do you know what the rate is for the EMTs?
I have it at 0.047.
0.047.
Yeah. Now, workers' comp, is this an insurance policy?
Yeah.
Okay. So we're not, it's not that we're self-funded for this. This is a...
No, yeah. Okay. This is through Maya. We're with Maya again. This will be the going into the third year. We've had them 2 years, right?
Yes.
This year is our second year, so. So I wasn't quite sure last year coming into the budget season what to expect, because we only had the 1 year with Maya and they had kind of told us what to invoice. But we just got our audit done for the 15-16 and we got a credit of $2,000. So it was almost like on the button. So I'm going to stay with the same formula.
Okay.
But so I just.
That's pretty unusual.
I do the calendar year payroll times the rate for each department, like Mary was just referring to. I do a 2% increase just for payroll changes, and I come out with the number that you see before you, 85,710. Okay. Then I subtract out by the departments the ones that are going to offset, mm-hmm. and there you have it.
What was the increase in employees from last year to this? The number of employee increase?
Oh, the number? I don't really have that.
Yeah, it goes by payroll, too.
No, it does. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's payroll dollars, but I will say that we, as on the town side, have been kind of shrunken this year. I mean, the selectman's office was down a couple people. EMS didn't really hire anybody else just recently, so we've been kind of on the.
That's why I'm wondering whether or not we'll be higher than what we anticipate.
Right, right. I did factor in the idea that we were missing two people when I did some of these payroll-generated budgets.
Great,
so.
Thank you.
So we should expect even more back because the selectman's office staff is way down, so they should send us.
I'm hoping it's going to increase.
Not as expensive as
Well, EMS is the biggest one, isn't it? Or the equipment operators or the.
For payroll, yeah.
For workers' comp.
It's school is huge. School's they're the monster.
Really?
In the building. Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
On what's the rate? Rate wise.
Our calendar year payroll for everything, school, yeah. town, everything.
Oh, I know. There's.
It's 6.2, and they are 4.3 of it.
4.3 million. But what's the percentage? School percentage. That's what I was talking about. The percentage or the comp rate.
Because you have different rates for different jobs.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well,
which
the
is
cafeteria and custodians are a 0.0334, and the rest of the staff is 0.0067.
Teachers.
And the highway is
higher than the cafeteria.
No, they're lower than the cafeteria.
Right, lower. There's another zero.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
What's the rate for South County or for the EMS?
0.047.
Oh, sorry. So
slightly higher.
4.7, just under 5%.
Yep.
And the how about police?
Police are under a different.
Okay.
Yeah.
Highway department.
Highway is 0.0319.
Okay, so South County, the EMS is the mm-hmm. big one, percentage wise. Okay, did we vote this, or do we need to take a vote?
No.
Okay.
Vote it.
Are we voting the 52-238?
We are.
Okay.
Motion?
Motion.
Second?
Second.
Moved, seconded?
We already had a motion from John.
Oh, John made it?
Okay, whomever. You're keeping track of that, so.
That's okay. Who got a second?
Jeff,
all right.
Second.
Yep.
It's moved, seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
So 52-238.
Mm-hmm.
Unemployment insurance.
Well, it's getting worse and worse the more deeper we go in these budgets. The unemployment, I'll tell you, that is overdrawn this year already. So. Mm-hmm. You never know what this is going to be, something or nothing. It seems like there's a lot of, it's all school. First of all, unemployment, I don't think we've paid one town unemployment claim this year.
We're going to see if we can do something about that.
There's been, I can't even tell you the traffic that's going on at the school between hiring and firing.
Your predecessor.
It's just, it's a busy, busy.
Mm-hmm.
Unemployment, we appropriated just over 12,000, and we've expended 15.7, almost 15.8. And It'll probably be another, what do we got? Another 12,000, probably.
So how are we going to do that? Are you going to come back to us?
Yeah, once we see what, how it all ends, but currently we're, you know, negative 3,700.
And we still have 5 months to go.
So do you want to budget for that kind of year again, or, you know, it's hard to say.
We don't know.
Exactly.
That's, when we go through the insurance budget and the rest of these, then we can, we can have a chat on this. This is one of the, this is one of the ones that we do want to talk about.
We, I mean, if you look at the history of it, in 15, it was, we expended 16.7, just over 9,000 in 16, and then this year it's going to be probably 25,000.
Now, we expended 49,000 in 2014. Is that accurate?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know, Mary, did we? It looks like it. That's what it says.
That's what it says.
Well, that was the year they cut all that staff, wasn't it?
No, that was the year you had to pay all those back years.
Yes. Oh, right.
Oh, okay.
That's what it was.
That's okay.
That was an accumulation of years. So.
Yeah, I remember that one.
I would say that, I mean, judging by the graph here, this is that kind of budget. Who knows?
That's because we're self-insured, right?
Yes.
And the RIDEA, the management company, as they take care of the reporting and stuff?
I will say they've been fantastic resource. Not only do they help guide us through certain kind of, even beyond unemployment, even just like payroll kind of HR situations, but they represent us on all cases. We've had a couple of cases where they've gone, several cases that they've gone to court for us. So
how have they made out?
Well,
that's the
yeah. We have benefited significantly more than the $2,000 that it's cost, for sure.
Okay.
We could have been 100% successful if we had the cooperation of all that we needed in each of those cases, but that's not always the case.
And the time that she's saving, not going to those hearings.
Yeah.
Like
tremendous.
I say, it's hard, a little bit difficult, because most of these are school employees, so there's that disconnect between me trying to communicate with the guy and tell him, why is this person lose their job, and then this, I need the school to participate as well, and if they don't always want to. So.
Okay. Any further questions? Can we have a motion on this?
Make a motion that we approve $17,150.
It's moved. Second?
I'll second.
It's moved and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? Okay.
I'm gonna write a little note on
okay.
that.
Okay. Now the next one is the one that we choke on.
Yeah. Yeah.
Group health insurance.
Group
this
health
is
insurance.
Health insurance, right?
Mm-hmm. $1 million.
All right, sounds good to me.
Yep.
Let's just vote it.
I've done it roundabout. I've done it in excruciating detail, and it comes out the same.
What? Where's the increase?
Well, there's a rate increase on the policies. On average, 10%. I brought it here for you guys to refer to if you'd like to. It's 9.4% on the HMO plans and 10.8% on the PPO plans. So there was already, MedEx went up a little bit. Their plans changed in January, so they went up 8.3%. Yeah, they went up last year. This might be, it's at least the second increase, if not the third year. Yeah. Just recently.
So I'm also assuming that there's an increase in the participation.
Yes, I did a little, I wondered that myself. So what I did, just for ha-has, is I looked at last January and this January just to see what was happening. And the police, their cost is down $1,000. Highway's down 400, town offices is down more than 3,000. South County EMS is up 200. The school for 1 month, from 1 January to the next January, is up almost $15,000.
1 month?
For 1 month.
Mm-hmm.
Retirees are up 4,000, but they're already appreciating the 8.3 increase at this point. So so that'll give you an idea of, we're pretty stable, if well, shrunken with the understaffing, but
so all
15,000 in the school for a month times 12.
180 just for round figures.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
180 just for round figures.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and so 65% of that is our costs.
Yeah.
Now, for the shared teachers, do you have to do the billing to mm-hmm. the other towns?
Yes.
And you do that?
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Does anybody pay you?
Yes.
I know a lot of towns were not paying.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you know if there was an increase in the school staff?
I was nervous about this account from the get-go, because we have open enrollment is the first 2 weeks in May.
Right,
of course,
right.
We've already voted everything. And they were coming out of the woodwork signing up for plans. And I went over to Casey and I'm like, I already know, or Doug or whoever, I already know we're going to be over budget and the year hasn't even started yet. But apparently between us being low and it's not too bad, and our offsets from South County EMS and everything, I think we might make it, right?
We'll be close.
Yeah, yeah.
So you don't think we're going to spend significantly more than the $820,000 that we
no,
have?
No, I think we're going to somehow.
Well,
I don't really know how it all worked out, but somehow it's going to come out.
We probably ought to take a look at it just before town meeting, or what's the minimum time, 14 days? 21 days, something like that, before town meeting in by the end of March, so that
mm-hmm.
if we need to
yeah.
put that on as an article.
Yeah. Well, we did the mid-year offsets to see what we thought, how it was tracking, and
yeah.
so I think we thought we'd be okay.
All right.
Or if we needed any, it would be minimal.
Yeah,
okay.
Probably within my budget.
Could you tell me what percentage of this budget, the $1 million budget, is from the schools?
Offhand, I would say 70%. I would say more than two-thirds is school.
Okay. Two-thirds conservatively.
Yep. Yep. I've done it many, many times, and it always comes out
mm-hmm.
about two-thirds.
And
last
the reason
time
I
did,
asked,
it was a little more than two-thirds.
The reason I asked that question
yeah.
was because people keep saying that we don't spend that much on schools, and my standard answer has been for the last 20-something years,
mm-hmm.
we spend over three-quarters of every dollar on the schools.
Mm-hmm.
When you take the money that goes directly to the schools, you take and add the unemployment benefits, you add the insurance benefits,
mm-hmm.
and when you do that, we're between 75% and 80% of all of our money goes directly to education.
Absolutely.
In one form or another.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not complaining, I'm just saying
right.
you got to face facts, and those are the facts.
Right.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
How many plans do we offer? How many HMO plans, how many PPO plans?
On the HMO, we have a single employee plus one or family. And on PPO...
One provider.
Yes, it's all Blue Cross
all
Blue
Shield.
It's all Blue Cross, only one provider. We're through the Hampshire County
yeah.
Group Trust.
And they are good.
They're fantastic. Yeah.
Yes.
Yep. Yep.
So nobody can pick a high-end plan or a low-end plan.
Right. The HMO
yeah.
is...
Understood.
Less expensive.
Less expensive.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But not by a lot.
Not by a lot. No, but we will, since we're talking a little bit about the trust, the upcoming meeting, they're going to be kind of contemplating what can we do to keep the cost down, because we
yeah.
have had increases over the last couple years. And with these increases, they're using capital to offset. I mean, if we just went by the cost of it, those would have skyrocketed. So it's mostly prescription, I guess, that's really out of, exploding in costs.
Mm-hmm.
So the next few meetings, they will be talking about possible ways that we could contain costs and maybe changing plans or limiting plans or, I don't know. So anyway.
EpiPens? Anyone?
Uh-huh. They do, they have the Canada RX where people can get prescriptions for free or very reduced, and really tried everything. And the EpiPens is a perfect example of a way to save on those.
So do you want to move this?
I'd like to put it on hold and revisit it myself.
Okay.
I'm just curious as far as, is it same percentage being paid across the board by all employees?
Retirees are 50-50, and all active employees pay 35%.
Okay.
You have to keep it the same. It's still, the rule is still the same, right? But you have to keep it the same percentage across.
Same percentage.
So did you still want to put a hold on that, or?
Yeah, I would. I'd like to put a hold on this and revisit it, you know, a little later down the road. Or if you guys want to move it forward.
Well, the thing is, you can move it and you can still bring it back up later.
I'm
not sure. I mean, I can understand that it's a major increase to put a hold on it, but what's going to change?
I agree.
That's the issue. The issue is we can still open it up once we get more information.
And we could open it up if and for example, on some of these, I mean, if you have to come back and say we need $20,000 more in something.
We don't have enough money in our excess fund.
Well, we'll see. That's part of the reason that I would like to be able to get all of these, get through all of these, and then let's add them all up, see what we got for revenues, and see where we're ahead or short.
Yes, I plan to continue to monitor these as the year goes on, and I'd certainly, you know, ask to speak to you all if something changed.
So
let me make a motion. We can pass it. We can always revisit it later. I'll move the $920,989.
Is there a second?
I'll second.
Second. Any other discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Abstain.
Noes? So it's 4 in favor.
401.
401. 1. Okay. Medicare insurance. What did we vote last year?
On that, 86,570.
There's up on the very top. I didn't see anything up there. That's why I was wondering. We didn't have the offsets for. Okay, whatever. It's immaterial. Any questions?
Yeah, yes, why don't we have an offset on the skims?
They have their own, don't
What's
they?
What's that?
They have their own skims? No
yes.
offset?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's correct. It gets billed directly.
Through their
payroll.
Mm-hmm. How about South County Senior Center?
Well, Barbara and I talked about that. We determined that it was minimal enough that we didn't want to deal with it in this budget. We'll still budget for it in the South County Senior Center budget, but we didn't think it was enough to play with.
Okay.
All right. Make a motion. We approve the $89,700.
We have a motion. Do we have a second?
I'll second.
It's moved, seconded. All those in favor, $89,700.
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? Medical Security Act.
Make
we didn't
a motion
vote this
approve
before?
That.
Okay.
$50.
Any questions? Other than, okay, what is it?
Placeholder.
No,
the town isn't obliged to pay it. So, but we always had it in the budget because you never know when they're going to change the rules.
That's right.
Oh, is that it? Okay.
Huh?
That's what it was for?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, because there was talk at the top one time that they were going to start charging municipalities for it. And
really?
Yeah.
Okay, so
I moved it.
It's moved. Is there
second.
A second? Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Unanimous.
You like that one?
$50 is the cheapest one we did.
Tonight, yeah. We had a $20 one before, though. The Oliver Smith will. $20. That's a good one.
That's true, too.
We have one more here, Veterans Day and Memorial Day expense before we...
Veterans benefits.
I have the veterans benefits as my...
What's the number on that one?
It is...
About the fifth or sixth one in.
Yeah.
$543.5410.
$543.5410. 54. Veterans, is that Veterans District Assessment?
No, Veterans Benefits.
The next one, Veterans Benefits.
I don't have it. Is that a...
That's what you got in the distribution tonight.
It is?
Second, it's the third one in, where's the town clerk's expense?
No, I'm just saying previously, I don't have it in mind.
Oh, Veterans Benefits. Okay. $30,000.
Yep.
Right, okay.
What's that?
That's $30,000 bucks?
I think we're okay at $30,000. Yeah, we did $35,000 last few years.
Make a motion, we approve the $30,000?
Our monthly claims are about $1,850 a month. So at one point, they were $2,200, but it's been $1,850 for a number of months now, so for the last couple of months. Yeah, and before, so...
Plus, whatever we spend in this account, we get three-quarters of it back from the state.
We do get reimbursed, yeah.
How long does it take to get that money back now? Do you have any idea?
What's that?
How long it takes them to get the money back to us?
Oh, I've been watching it, so it happens.
Fairly regular, no?
Yeah. I make a note of my expenses, and then I see the veterans reimbursement. So I think, I mean, they do it quarterly reimbursement, I think is what it is. And it's within a month or two of the end of the quarter.
Yeah, because it used to be a long time.
Oh, really? Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
Because that used to be subject to appropriation, but now it's a lot better than it was.
Yeah, is that right? Yeah.
I had four other items that I checked off.
How about the memorial? How about voting this first?
Oh, okay, sorry. Motion?
So moved.
That's $30,000, Veterans Benefits, $30,000.
Yeah.
Second?
Second.
It's moved, seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Unanimous?
Then we have Veterans Day and Memorial Day expense.
Yeah, we do have that someplace.
Next one.
That's number 692, so it's at the very end of, well, I just, it's one of those I handed out in your box.
That's a flat $2,000. I spent that last year.
Or this year.
This current year, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Was that what John wanted or asked for?
That is what John asked for. I spoke to him today.
Any questions on this one?
Nope.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
It's moved. Is there a second? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay.
Got the whole packet done today. Boy, you're on a good meeting.
All right. Oh, we aren't finished yet.
It's okay. We're moving, though.
We are.
We're going to hold on the clerk treasurer collector's salaries?
Until we get the salaries.
Because it's salary.
Yeah, let's see. Let me just check this thing off, make sure I've got it here. Okay. Where the hell is it? Okay.
Brenda, what's the account number for that? For the clerk treasurer collector's salaries, what's the account number?
That one is, you know what, that one...
$145,510.
But it's...
$145,510.
$145,510. Yep.
We don't have that memorized, Mary?
Yeah, that one did not print. I'm sorry, I didn't print on that one. It keeps reverting back. If I don't pay attention and do it every single time, I have to do something to make that number show up, so... Doug is coming on Friday. I'm going to make him fix it.
So we're not going to do the salaries.
No.
But we can do treasurer collector expense.
We did it.
We did it.
That's the first one we did.
Right, that was the one we started with.
Okay, how about legal? I've got checked off legal expense to do that tonight. Is that...
So, yep, you and I talked about doing that one today.
Okay.
What number is it?
It's 161, or excuse me, 151, 5300.
Is it in here?
No, it's old one.
It's an old one?
No, it was in our packet, was it?
It is one that I handed out maybe the last week.
Want me to make copies?
It's right behind the collector's salary. 151, 5300, right?
Yeah, it should be right behind Oliver Smith, trustee, but I don't know if you all put them in your binders or not.
I did, but I didn't put them in order. 151.
Okay, so.
I got it.
Everybody's got it now?
Yep.
That's all I had to do.
That's it.
That's right.
All right, that worked.
That opens right back.
The only question I got on this one is that enough money in there? Wendy?
I went through it, of course. We talked about it as well.
Because we usually have to add to it.
I'm sorry, I think we were on, we're going to have higher costs for things we had to manage over the last couple months, but hopefully within this budget, so that's why.
The last 3 years, we've gone way over.
Me being here, we won't need council as much. I'm hoping to manage those costs.
Thank you.
And we have a lot of hot buttons going on now that we've had to call.
So what you're saying is accept the 23.7?
I'm happy. I'm hopeful and happy about that. Yeah, I did go through it.
The selectmen are happy with that?
I don't know. We will talk about that.
It's too late.
It's on the agenda.
Well, we're going to vote that portion, then we'll discuss it with them.
Tell them it's too late.
Make a motion, we approve 23.7?
Seconded.
Moved, seconded. Any further discussion? If there isn't any, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Unanimous?
Some of the expenses we had, I think anticipated for this year, was negotiating the cable contract and the police contract.
We saved on the police contract.
Yes, we did, but.
No.
We paid too. That's in another budget.
Okay. Town clerk expense.
We did that one.
Did we do that one?
Yep.
We can do it again.
Wait a minute.
What are you doing?
Okay, I've got, I didn't check it off. You're right, it is. And I'm not sure why I didn't check it off. Anything else? How about town office? I've got town office expense.
General office and general.
General insurance, we voted those?
Those were two of them that we were talking about earlier. You have my list.
Town office and general?
So that would be 192,563.
Question is, what did they do with the sheets?
They're in the book from last week.
No, I mean, I didn't pull them out. I never really pulled them out. Let me see if I can find them. One, okay, town office expense, we did that one?
Nope, that's the one we wanted to do.
Okay. And general insurance?
And general insurance.
Okay, so we have those to do, all right.
And those are back to back.
Yep. So town office expense, 192,5430.
Yes.
Whose is that? Is that yours?
Yeah.
Okay, go for it.
What do you want to know? The transition of staff needs to, you know, supplies, just a slight bump to capture that. Telephone, we had a contract I've dropped for, we were, had this company that was monitoring our bills to see if they were billing us accurately. And for years, it was a little bit of a, we were, our bills was combined with the school, so we were combing through that. That got separated a couple of years ago.
Actually, just a couple months ago.
Couple months ago, so that's, any rate, I canceled those services. And they company acknowledged that really they weren't able to give us money.
They really didn't do anything.
It's a $100 a month thing. Reports, you knew about that in terms of.
Yeah, last year,
I don't know, I think it was Pat Kroll, decided to go somewhere else to print our town reports and saved us like, I don't know, $2,000-$3,000. So we've budgeted accordingly. You know, we bumped it up a little bit from what we paid last year just to cover anything unusual, but the $2,500 should do it.
She went to Staples, and she's compiling the report again this year, and you haven't gotten your report in. Please get your report in to Pat at the Select Board office. Okay. Sorry.
After we finish our work, I'll get it in.
That's it, I'm done.
No, after we finish our stuff, well, I'll give her the report.
Oh, I didn't mean you. I meant our listeners, our department heads that are all listening, and boards and officials that are listening.
So I'm not listening, so.
Probably sitting at home laughing at us.
Okay. General insurance.
Make motion to approve this one?
No.
Did we vote on this?
Oh, okay, sorry. Town office expense, $18,700. Is there a motion?
So moved.
Seconded?
Second.
Seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Unanimous? General insurance.
We were told to anticipate a 2% increase.
5%.
5%?
Mm-hmm.
What was the 2%? What was that on? Was that workers' comp? I thought it was 2. Okay.
So we did plan on a 5% increase, and then just buffered it with a couple more thousand just to be sure in case there was anything else that we weren't thinking of.
Okay, there's no sense in arguing with you. You're reducing it by $9,000, so if that's bumping it up by 5%.
It is over what we paid this last year. So
okay, all right.
We're happy with that.
So the $74,000 that we've got in there is more than we need? Okay.
Correct.
Okay.
We switched.
Make a motion, we approve $65,000.
Second.
It's moved, it's seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Unanimous. Okay.
Do you realize that we've already done more tonight than we've done in the first 3 weeks?
Thank you, John.
I was going to have the assessors, if they're available, come out and talk to us about their budget.
Sure. And they can wait if they want to, but they don't have to.
Well, but no, don't take off yet. I did want to talk, briefly, the insurances and the other benefit type things. I guess I would like to make the push for asking, you know, we're gonna put the money there, but I'd like to put that in, like we've done with South County EMS, put that into the school budget.
Yes.
And ask them to monitor that. They do it at Frontier, so it's not.
Why don't they put it in the budget, period?
No, it's not even in their budget.
I realize it's not in their budget.
No, I know, but why not just put it in their budget? I mean, obviously.
That's what he's saying.
That's what I'm saying.
You said just to monitor.
We don't want.
No. I meant, and let them monitor that.
Let them manage it.
They manage it.
Yeah.
It's.
That would be nice.
We're all on board.
And unemployment.
I said benefits. I said the benefits.
Okay, yeah.
Not just health insurance, but the whole benefit piece.
That's, you know, probably 75% of what Barbara does is manage most of that stuff for them.
And this shouldn't be that difficult, I mean, because they already do it for Frontier.
I mean, I think we would still need to, like, pay the bill and everything, you know?
They would send the bill to the town?
But well,
but I would be able to tell them what their bill is every month. Exactly.
They'd have to get a bill every month, and wherever they get it, and that'll go on the warrant, and they will sign the warrant and whatever when you get it over here.
Because honestly, in all fairness, I mean, they're probably oblivious to what the
absolutely
costs are and associated with their personnel.
And
no
I had
doubt
talked
about that.
I had talked with Patty a couple of years ago about this.
Yes.
And
I know.
There was an interest in being, you know, having that information.
Yes.
So.
Yes, definitely.
So, can I just, yeah.
Didn't we talk about, at the very least, breaking it out that way, so we know?
No, let's move it, let them take care of it.
Moving this way, I mean, we talked strongly about it last year.
And actually, if we can get the health insurance, Hampshire Trust, to send a bill to.
Can't do that.
Why?
I can do it.
Okay.
We have spreadsheets anyway, everybody, so I can do it.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean.
But we can't, can, are we, or can we at least break it out, showing the town side and the school side?
Well, actually, put the money.
Yeah, I'm just saying, show it, not necessarily, you know, what, how, if you want to do that, yes, but at least, the very least, just show it, what the actual.
Let's get it over, let's just get it over.
For 18?
And.
That's the question, can we do it for 18, or should we?
We know what the, we know.
Broach the subject and then say we want it for 19.
We know what the numbers are.
We did broach it last year, I mean, I thought we were really close to doing something last year with it, and obviously, their budget's going to be lopsided the year that it happens, and ours is going to be, you know, low, but afterwards, it should.
We can put another line item in the budget, same number, but just put it in there as, benefits, you know, so it says Deerfield Elementary School, Deerfield Elementary School benefits, and put the number in. And so that they can see what their budget was last year, the budget this year, and it's up 2-3%, whatever it is, and then this other number.
Yes.
And then next year,
it should be just okay.
Yes. Yeah.
Absolutely, and I'd be happy to facilitate that, or whatever they need.
You certainly can start the discussion. How about if?
Well, the administrators are meeting with the superintendent Thursday, so I can bring it up.
Well, the problem is that it won't be the other towns. Now, maybe the other towns will want to do that. Maybe the administrators ought to talk.
No, we're talking about elementary school. Frontier already does it for the others.
No, but you're talking about the town administrators.
The four towns, no, the multi-towns. Yeah.
The four towns.
No, but what do they do, and, you know, broaching the subject, but am I missing something here?
No, I don't think so.
Okay. So bringing this up.
They may all want to do it.
I yeah.
That's right.
It's a very interesting input into their budget, because nobody really understands that it's almost a couple million more for what the town actually picks up with, that they're not even looking at. So, especially when they're looking for large increases in their budgets.
Mm-hmm. So would that include the Franklin County retirement payment, 20%?
Sure.
Yeah. Anything that they would be charged.
It's hard to.
And then I think going forward, it would be easy to talk about sharing OPEB deposits
agree.
And that kind of thing, you know, if we know that it's not all of our.
Well, I'd kind of like to hang on to that one, because we're not going to be until they start, somebody starts billing us. But yeah, at the point in time somebody starts billing us for OPEB, then yes.
The general policy is they're not going to bill for OPEB. And one of the latest things that I've heard is that they're trying to force the issue after we square away the retirement issue in 2033. And if anything, you open up an account, keep the account active so you can manage it. And if you have money, to put it away. But if you don't have money, you won't be forced into doing anything until they turn around by state legislature and force you to do it after you upgrade your retirement funding to the full retirement fund. And that's what they're doing now with Frank County Retirement.
So we're talking one line item for employee benefits, and then another line item for.
Well, we could just have one line for benefits and then A, B, C, D, and list them all out. That way they see life insurance, health insurance, unemployment.
Yeah, I'd like to see them broken out.
Yeah.
Not just.
That way they know.
Not just one single line item.
No, one single line isn't educational to them.
Right, it isn't, because people won't know, but if you actually break it out.
So if we got six or eight lines underneath it, so be it. It's well worth it.
So you'll get back to us with that number? breakout?
For the recommended breakout for that.
For what measure?
For Deerfield Elementary School.
With a measure of what time?
18, budget.
Going forward.
Going forward.
I can report what last year's was at that expense?
Yeah, you may not have an expense in there for last year because those are expense for last year, but for going out for 18, for example, you take your insurance, and the insurance that you'll have will show 65% or 70% of the $1 million cost, which means that will open some eyes. It'll open eyes on a town meeting floor, and it'll open eyes at the school committee and everywhere else, because those are the real true expenses. The unemployment, those things, and when they see that, you know, we went up $20,000 on unemployment, and all of the expense goes to the school, what does that show you? And I think it's very important to break that out.
Is it going to be hard to show on a budget? I mean, is it going to be difficult to have a separate line item with sub-line items to it?
Not when you're good.
I understand that, but...
He'll figure a way to do it.
I don't want to make it too complicated.
Well, it doesn't make sense to have it in-house, but then have like a pie chart or something to show it, which would really have impact in terms of the present.
Well, when I was in group insurance, I figure out what have we been spending, and I usually factor in the rate increase and then maybe the 10% increase for pay adjustments and what have you. So, I mean, I can do the same thing for them, or I can report what their costs were last year if they're doing some budgeting and they want to allow for more or less. That's what you get into when you're dealing with someone who's about taking more of the responsibility. Same thing related to Zach. So I think he's going to spend this much. Well, he might say, well, I plan on hiring a few more people, so I'm going to do this much.
So we're going to, we'll do a line item for 18, 19, we're going to move it over to the schools.
This is Frontiers. So under an insurance account, they have insurance for active employees, then contract adjustments, I don't know what that is, insurance for retired school employees, other non-employee insurance, and they've got a grand total of $1,852,726. Now, I haven't seen workers' comp anywhere, and I haven't seen what was the other one, but someplace along the way. Well, their retirement, most of their retirement's
through the state.
Well, employer retirement contributions, $358,000. Their retirements are going to be significantly less than town of Deerfield because
they're subsidized by the state.
Teachers all go to Mass Teachers.
Right.
So, and there is no charge for that. So, in fact, we don't pay a charge for the elementary school.
But we still have a lot of county retirement employees at the elementary.
Yes. So, you know, the more they can put on Mass Teachers, and the deficit is picked up in the state budget. Okay, so I guess we're all tend to be in favor of doing that. Okay. So the next thing that we need to do is talk with the selectmen about it, and then you're going to talk with the other towns, administrators?
Mm-hmm. Just give them an idea and see if they want to do the same thing.
And again, I mean...
Let's see what they're doing. They could be, you know, breaking it out in terms of showing the distribution.
So the question is, when will you have that done? Will that be done? Will that be done by noontime
tomorrow?
So Wendy can take it to her meeting. Have this breakout done as a sample for you to present to the others.
I think we can just talk. I mean,
because I'm sure she could do that tomorrow morning, 15 minutes before her coffee break or right
She's
after.
She's already done.
She doesn't get
you didn't
breaks.
Notice.
She doesn't.
When was the last time you took a coffee break?
Yeah, I do
What's
have
coffee?
Okay, so
I know.
She brings her coffee with her. She sits at her desk.
Great.
I mean, just a discussion, basically, of doing it. And you're right. I think there is some I assume somewhere along the way there's going to be some resistance, but, you know, there was some acceptance. It's spent. It doesn't really make much difference.
Well, not only that, the town of Deerfield voters are the ones that are going to vote for it or not. So
right.
If they don't, what happens?
It's just a matter of where it's put, that's all.
It's not necessarily the number, it's the whole idea.
Yeah.
Idea.
Yes.
Yeah. So we have $1 million insurance budget, $650 of it is there. So
that's all I need to know.
$630 or $670 or something like that. Yeah.
Okay.
And that way, when they run short during the year, they can take it out of, they can lay off a teacher.
Oh, that would be wonderful.
And then again, back to that unemployment.
Exactly. Back to the unemployment, because now they know they laid them off.
That's right. Yeah.
The other towns have substantially less general government employees as well, so it's probably even more.
Well, we certainly skewed. Not the bigger schools, you know, so.
Well, when you do that, could you do me a favor and throw a copy in my box? And then I know Skip would probably want one. I'm not sure. I don't want to speak for anybody else.
Okay.
Before Skip lets you go, I want to thank you because you guys did a great job tonight.
Okay,
yes,
thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right.
Now you can go.
Happy Valentine's
Day. Oh, no. Yeah.
Merry Christmas.
Oh,
I've
had it open to assessors.
My,
okay.
One
see
of my.
Mark. Yes,
guys I work with, there was a
bye.
Giveaway today at 10 pounds of candy from
Richardson.
Okay.
Oh, yeah?
That's
a lot of chocolate.
That's a lot of chocolate.
What's the number?
I think I
okay.
Right behind.
Where are we going? 141.
What?
I'm not sure you have those.
What?
The assessors.
Yeah, we do.
Yes, we do.
Where?
Passed out weeks ago.
Accountant's salary.
I am looking in here. I don't see it.
That would have been. It would have been given first, to you in your binders.
Yeah, the first week.
Right.
The first week
early.
Yep.
And I'm sorry, the numbers didn't print on those.
That's look right. Under section three.
Yes,
section three. Yep.
Go
2-3 pages in, you'll find the
it's
assessor.
Right behind the accountant's
okay.
expense.
Right. Now, do you have any other budgets tonight?
I don't. Do you, Skip, do you want me to stick around or do you want me to go?
No. You're welcome to, obviously. But that'd be fine.
And thank you.
Thank you. Yeah.
I don't blame it.
You can fill me in tomorrow if there's anything I need to know.
I've got these so that you can. I'll give them to you. You can copy them off or not. Okay.
Recommendations.
Okay.
I didn't realize it was in here.
Yeah. All right.
After accountant salary.
Yep.
Salaries.
Come on up and join us.
Assessors. Expense. We have.
Assessors salaries. Assessors clerk.
Yep.
Expense.
Assessors salary. Assessors
clerk
salary.
Yeah. Assessors expense.
What a prestigious group.
Assessors. I wanted to talk with you in particular about the salaries for the three of you, actually. And my question really is typically, at least in the past, there's been an effort to keep salaries of the assessors aligned with the salary of the selectmen. And that went by the wayside at town meeting last year. And so, for discussion purposes, the floor is yours.
Well, obviously, we need
parity.
Something to be done.
Yeah.
So we're suggesting that, again, we're trying to be as conservative as we can be, so we're trying to do some increments
So we were asking this year is a $500 bump in the chairman and $250 for each of the other assessors. We're still not up anywhere near where
about
the selectmen
half
are.
Or something like that.
And I would foresee that the next several years we would come back with the same, about the same progression to try to get it up there a little bit. Last calendar year, 2016, I just roughly tried to track some of the time. And, you know, there's
you're not getting paid minimum wage, probably.
Exactly.
And I don't.
You're not even getting paid gas money, probably.
Depends on whether you drive a
I don't know what
big
the minimum
SUV
wage is right now, to be honest with you, but it's bad.
Okay. I don't have a problem with it. I don't know if anybody else does.
No.
Excessive salaries.
No, not at all.
I don't have a problem. The only question I get is why aren't you going up even more?
Well,
we're just trying to be conservative.
Again, we're trying to, we recognize, you know, that the town is kind of strapped right now, and we're trying to, again, do it slowly.
Okay.
Rather than just coming
I mean, that would have,
all
that would
have
quite honestly
all I can say
been
is thank you, and I make a motion we approve the $8,000.
Any other questions?
No.
Okay. We have a motion, assessor salaries for $8,000. It's moved and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
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 It's voted unanimously.
And thank you again.
How about our administrative assistant?
We're not going to talk about that yet.
We're
waiting for the town to set the.
Yeah.
Okay.
But that's the only reason.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Okay. We will talk about expenses, though. The request is no change from last year.
Again.
Selectmen going to do the same thing?
Selectmen's
expenses?
Did you do that?
No, I haven't. I was just curious. The assessors aren't increasing their expenses. Are the assessors not increasing? I mean, the selectmen, are they not increasing their expenses? I don't know.
No, I don't think so.
I thought since we gave them $1,000 in payroll, we could cut this one by
$1,000. Any questions on the assessor's expenses?
I'm only kidding about that.
We were asked to hold it.
I know.
Okay. And we did.
Yeah, no, it's fine.
Since it's the same as last year, I make a motion we approve $21,535.
I'll second that.
We have a motion and a second to assessor's expense at $21,535. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? Okay. And you want to talk to us about the recertification process or what the changes in that, just so that we can have an idea?
Yeah, that's kind of a.
We'll vote that budget too. I like voting that budget.
Real quick.
That's kind of up in the air at the present time. We're going into a five-year recertification instead of a three.
Mm-hmm. I assume that's state law?
Yeah, that's state law. What we've been doing in the past is appropriating or asking for an appropriation each year to put
mm-hmm.
into, I like mm-hmm. to call this a revolving account.
Yep. No, I think it is. Not sure. Probably have it someplace.
Here it is. I've got it, yeah. And we've been, for the past several years, we've been putting $20,000 into it.
Yep.
Where we will be for the coming for the upcoming, when we get into this five-year cycle, we don't know. We've got to go out for RFPs again. But we assume it'll be somewhere in the same neighborhood. It's, you know, been 19.5. We requested 2015 and 16. It was 19.5. We appropriated 20. In 2014, there was a spike because that was a recertification. So there was extra work to do.
That was a 9-year recertification.
See, again, what we try to do is parcel it out so that we keep up. I assume we've been trying to do 1/3 of the properties mm-hmm. for 3 years. I assume we'll do now 1/5 each year, 20%.
That makes sense.
Does that include personal property? Do you do that too?
Well, we do personal property, but it's kind of a different ball of wax.
Yeah.
That's not a recertification. That you're supposed to, you do on an annual basis, more or less.
Yeah.
Supposedly. Annual, yeah.
Yeah, because you don't go back out and,
right.
you know, do in-depth analysis of, you know, sales and all that kind of stuff. It's just, mm-hmm. it's pretty, a little bit more cut and dried for personal property.
Occasionally do physical audits or go out and look at the...
Yes, Patriot Properties sends a person out there to check to see what machinery, equipment, that kind of stuff there is on the premises. I'm not sure that we do real small businesses, but mm-hmm. the larger ones we certainly do.
Yes, they do. They did mine.
They did yours?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. So what do you got? 4 desks, 2 chairs, and a couple computers.
Of filing cabinet. Yeah.
And they were used when you bought them.
Sixteen
pencils with
back when I was in practice.
One sharpener.
They did mine 1 year anyway. I remember them coming in.
And then just sent you the same bill every year after
and
that.
And it was the same every year afterwards. Yeah.
Okay. So the request that we've got from you is $0.
Right. Well, that's because we have money in the account. I don't remember how much.
For next year.
But there is money in that account,
it says,
correct?
You got $7,000 from the previous contract left to pay. That you need to pay yet, right?
Right.
Yeah, but I don't know how much is. I don't know how much is in there.
We're looking at different. What are you looking at, Mary?
We had that
it's right
somewhere,
on the bottom.
But I don't
have nothing on the bottom.
We
have anything on the bottom either. I want to say it was running 4 years.
This is recertification.
Yeah.
Much so I printed out. Mm. I think one of our readings.
You want to
quickly
see?
Well,
we just want to make sure you're not shortchanging yourself.
We just wanted to make sure that this.
Well, that's what I want to make sure, too.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
To be honest with you, I got misled. I didn't get all this stuff together because I thought the only thing you were discussing was salaries.
Yeah, that's the only thing we're not discussing.
And that's the only thing you're not discussing. Right. I got misled. I spent time getting fired up for Karen.
Ta-da.
And you're not even going to talk about it.
No.
We already know she's good, so it's not a problem.
Okay.
The only question is, what can we afford as a town for a percentage increase?
I know.
Now,
I know.
What we could do is we could agree to follow the same pay raise they give to Social Security recipients, 0.3%.
I think you should follow the same pay raise they gave to our legislators.
Yes. I was thinking that we ought to get that. We can go off the. Has that usually been the situation where they vote it, but it doesn't take effect until after the next election?
Yeah.
Greedy SOBs, aren't they?
Well, that's what most states do. Let's put it that way.
I could see a raise for them, but not.
$29,343.
In there now?
So when do you expect, and that includes the $20,000 from last year that we voted?
The current year.
In the current year, so the FY '17.
They got $29,000, so they probably have enough, but you don't know what they're going to run into for this quintennial recertification requirement.
Well, out of that $29,000.
More than $20,000 a year.
Out of that $29,000, we got it seven. We got to pay out seven.
Right, so $22,000.
So roughly, there's roughly $20,000.
So you're satisfied with $0 then?
Yeah, I think we can probably get away for 1 year without funding it.
I was just going to say that next budget year, though, you're going to see, taxpayers are going to see a huge jump. That's all. Even though we know.
You encumber the balance, right?
Yeah, I mean, starting, yeah, next year it'll be back up to.
But do you encumber the balance, John?
How you budget over the next 5 year versus three. So it could level.
Do you encumber the balance? I mean, is it an article? I don't remember. Is it an article in warrant or?
Yeah, it's a warrant article.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, that's why it stays.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll have to see what the RFP comes up with and, you know, what they're going to do to spread it out. I can't imagine that it's going to be a lot different in terms of total dollars. Mm-hmm. Instead of being over 3 years, it'll be over five.
5 years.
Patriots Property, along with everybody else, is going to figure out some way that they can increase it by 60%.
They still want to get their $20,000 every year.
That's right. Yeah.
No, they're not going to want to reduce it.
Okay. I don't have a problem with it. I don't know if we don't have to vote it since there's nothing in there.
But yeah, I think we do.
We do? Make a motion.
So move.
What are you moving?
Zero.
Okay. So this is the assessors recertification. And what's the, we don't know what the account number is, do we?
Couldn't find it.
No.
Do you sign the list back?
No.
Okay.
Matter of fact, I don't even see it listed on this.
No, because there's nothing, that's why.
Yeah.
Okay. So we've got a motion. Is there a second?
Maybe a second.
Okay, it's moved and seconded. $0 for the assessor's quintennial. Is it quintennial?
Quintennial.
Quintennial.
So that's 5 years, right?
Yeah, 5 years.
Recertification, yeah. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? $0. Okay.
Oh, it is on there.
What?
It's on warrant articles.
Okay. It's under warrant articles?
Yeah.
Speaking of warrant articles, the other item that just wanted to talk about is, let me see if I can find it here.
$120,000 that they're holding back?
Yeah, yeah. The overlay process. What? Two things. Are you able to release any overlay surplus?
Can't tell you right now.
Could have. Okay. So we should estimate.
For now, I would.
Nothing.
Just. Say, yeah.
Or you want to take a 5 year average? Or is that not something good to do?
I don't have any of that paperwork.
Okay.
So
sometime before town meeting?
Oh yeah, we can.
Okay.
We'll have at least have a handle on it.
Okay. So say by the end of March, since we have to put the
sure.
town warrant together.
Sure.
Okay. Yeah. And overlay, that is nothing that we actually budget.
No. That is something
that you work out on the recap.
That works on the recap sheet, exactly. Okay. Right.
The third one, new growth. We're going to use 50,000 unless we hear something better from you guys.
Yeah.
If you want to throw a bigger number out later on, then, but right now, we're looking at 50,000 for new growth.
That's a good conservative number.
Or at the end of March, we, it doesn't, yeah, but those are.
My gut reaction is that's a fair amount.
Okay.
I mean, we get a sense in looking at the deeds that are coming in, the sales that are taking place, you know, we're getting a sense that properties are being sold for quite a bit more than what we have them assessed for currently.
Yeah, I was surprised at some of that that I was seeing.
We just saw one tonight that a former assessor, I'm sure, will be back in wondering why his property's going up.
Don't worry, Bruce is normally sitting here, but he's on vacation.
Yeah, I know. He'd be here otherwise.
Well, I was wondering if you told Dick that, geez, you know your old house sold for $150,000 more than you sold it for? Or something like that.
We had some properties in Old Deerfield that sold for a lot more money than what they were valued at.
Well, yeah, that's a...
No,
well,
I'm not talking about... I'm not
Old
talking
Deerfield
about
is a, another whole story. Most of the stuff up there is being bought by
Deerfield
Academy.
Right, but you did have a couple properties that were transferred up there, right? On Memorial Street?
I can't remember. Maybe, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. In La Calios, what are they doing there?
Where?
Well, I don't know what... La Calio used to own it. I don't know who owned it afterwards.
Yeah.
The barn alone is... enormous amount.
There's 50,000 right there.
There could be. There could be.
In one property, yeah.
Oh, yeah, we'd have a better...
Okay, no, that's fine.
We can narrow it down.
Yeah.
And certainly overlay, we could have a pretty solid figure, too.
Okay.
You know, what excess there is. We're still... Part of the problem with overlay is we're still involved with the telephone companies and... I mean, where that going to finally shake out, I don't know.
We'll keep badgering you guys until town meeting. We're going to get out of you one way or the other.
But
what you should do is you should do the same thing that Comcast does. They follow a very modern billing technology. They went up 8% on their bill this year, so you ought to go up 8% on their thing. What's good for the goose is good for the gander.
Well, unfortunately, the state, right, they control the numbers for Verizon.
Public utility, yeah. But...
Yeah, but they, some utilities are okay, and others are getting greedy. There's a big difference there. You know, you can have a phone bill and have it for 20 years and start off with a $10 bill and you have a $20 bill. Then you get another utility that starts off with a $50 bill, and now they're a $100 bill.
It's.
And they say
it's complicated.
Any further questions?
No, I want to just compliment them. I think they're doing a great job, and I appreciate the fact that they're conservative by nature.
Sometime, and whether it's the middle of March, we're going to try to have joint meeting or combined meetings, whatever you want to call it, between the Finance Committee, Selectmen, Assessors, and just so that we can go over some of these numbers and see what they look like. so.
Well, Skip wants to invite you along. We don't want you to feel left out.
We, no, I mean, we want support.
We set those dates.
15th?
Back in the 29th.
There's a problem with the 20. I don't know why we need more than one, you know.
One meeting is all we need.
One, yeah.
There's a joint meeting date?
It looks like the 15th. We'll see how we get through the 15th of March, excuse me, not tomorrow.
What day is that?
Wednesday.
Wednesday.
Just like the 15th of February.
I think I'm leaving the 16th, so I think.
So you should be able to make it then. Where are you going? No, no income taxes this year, sir.
I thought you didn't leave till April 16th.
No, not anymore.
Not anymore.
Yeah, Skip will be around.
That's corporate. That's a corporate deadline. You not working till midnight?
No, not that night.
How about you?
Not public anymore, so.
Oh.
All right.
Thanks again.
Thank you very much.
It's true.
Any other questions that we have? I don't think so. Thank you very kindly.
Still need to bring the planning board in.
Pardon?
The planning board needs to come in.
We need to talk with the planning board, and we need to talk with the rec department.
Yeah.
You're leaving tomorrow or Thursday?
No, Friday.
Friday? So police department's coming in next week. Dick Kalaszewski is coming in for the health and inspectors.
I won't be here next week.
Okay.
I'll be late.
Well, what time?
I might not have a quorum.
What, we're going to need you for the quorum.
Well, I have a public hearing at 7 in Leverett. We'll go to 7:30 anyway.
Oh, good. Next week, Wednesday. Can we meet Wednesday?
That's what I'm saying. We're talking about next Wednesday?
No.
Yes. No, we are talking about next. Can we?
Next Tuesday.
I can't meet
next Tuesday.
Yeah,
I can't meet next Tuesday.
Okay. I can't meet next Tuesday either.
Okay.
How about?
I vote on that. I can't make it either.
We can call you.
I can't either.
I don't care what you call me. No, won't
by
talk to me.
By telephone, that's right. You don't know what a cell phone is. You're like
yeah,
me.
I do. I got one in my pocket, but
do,
I don't
really?
Use it.
So when do you want to meet?
Good question. If we can't meet Wednesday.
I can meet Wednesday.
You can meet Wednesday?
Tuesday is my public hearing.
Okay.
You want to do
Wednesday
at 6:30?
22nd.
No, this is the, this would be,
yeah
the 22nd.
22nd.
You're going to have to fight with the selectmen for this room.
And somebody else has got it too, I think. I think the rec department has it too. Maybe not. Maybe it was, 22nd, yeah.
6:30 or 7. 6:30, 7.
Was it 6:30 tonight?
Yep.
It was, and there's an even. I went looking for your telephone number and couldn't find it very quickly, so I
so you didn't tell me.
Well, yes, I did. There's an email that went to you, but.
Oh well.
I should know better because I don't look at emails either for 2 or 3 days. So, yeah.
I thought I was the only one that did that.
Huh? I did call John. I called somebody else too.
I returned my email.
Yeah. I haven't read that one yet, though.
It's okay.
So at least you know I'm coming.
So 6:30
or 7?
6:30 is fine with me.
6:30 is great. Good.
Since you were talking about it, this is the draft temp select board administrative office expense, okay? This is Franklin County, Franklin Regional Council of Government salary survey in Franklin County. Select board, Board of Health on the back. See if you can see. And this is same survey, assessors and assessors staff on the back. Okay. Oh, there'll be extra copies. I'll get them for you.
So they've done all the employees, the Franklin County survey. They did highway department.
They didn't have senior staff. know, and then I got this right away, and I said, I asked them about it, they said, no one's ever asked. So, anyway, pretty much, including fire service.
Yep, fire, EMS. Be nice to have all of them, unless we can go, we can just go and print them out. I mean, we can do that, too.
It's wobbly information.
Do you use these when you...
It's nice to see that the, in Deerfield, that the selectmen are the highest paid selectmen in the...
In the area.
But look, that's why I put the Board of Health on the back, because they are the Board of Health as well. So you could combine those figures.
And instead of coming up with 1,500, we'd come up with 2,500. Still makes them the highest paid.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna guess that many of the towns, the Board of Health is the same as the...
Well, it doesn't say that.
Well, Montague's not.
Holly is?
Holly, the selectmen, Holly, they elect the Board of Selectmen, that's all they elect.
Monroe, everybody in town is either selectman.
Yeah.
All right.
So there is an increase in draft.
That's, I can speak to that. I think it's primarily because of procurement officer training that I need to do. Training expense is the biggest bump in that budget?
Yep, that's the biggest increase.
Okay.
Half of it.
The selectmen haven't looked at this yet, though, have they?
No.
Okay.
That's why I put draft on everybody's copy.
Yeah, okay, so next week? Are you, the selectmen meeting tomorrow?
No, next week.
Hmm?
Next week.
Next week, okay, so it'll be... We could do it, well, no, we'll do it the week after or something.
You could talk to them, we could talk to them. I've sent them the budgets for their review.
Fine.
Six.
So, let them, they send it back.
Very long night.
So again, we've got police department coming in.
Can they still come there on the 22nd?
I think so. I'll double check. And Dick is coming in. I think the rec department. Who else am I?
You're gonna meet them there.
So they'll be able to do Wednesday?
There, or if worse comes to worse, we'll ask to use the police.
Capital planning meeting? They often meet the same...
That's right. We wanted to do capital.
But are they meeting? Because they often meet the same night.
They're gonna meet at 5:30.
Okay.
So when they get finished with theirs, you know, we can look at the capital budget. And so we'll talk about the capital budget. We'll also talk about capital stabilization. Creating that account. And it's, as I understand it, the idea is that if we voted a capital stabilization amount, so let's say we vote $200,000 for capital stabilization at town meeting in April, that would be the money that the Capital Improvement Committee would have available for next year's annual town meeting. They would, in other words, they'd go through the thing, and to fund it, they would take it from capital stabilization, whatever the number is. Then we put another $200,000 or something like that into capital stabilization.
I just don't want to see, I just don't want to see the it being depleted every year.
Well,
right, we don't want to see it depleted.
If we're gonna put $250,000 in, it's a placeholder for projects that are approved by the Capital Improvement Committee.
Yes.
Right.
But then I don't want to put $250,000 in and say, this is how much you got for next year.
Yeah,
I don't want to.
Because it's gonna be all spent.
Well, and what's the purpose of doing it?
I think the purpose of putting it in and working towards, at least you have money there.
A reserve fund.
But that doesn't mean you have to spend it all.
Capital expenses come up.
If you do that, then you have to put it into a stabilization account, which requires a 2/3 vote to take it out.
And that's what we put in.
That's what I would like to see.
Okay, so...
Because it's good check and balance.
I agree with you.
So explain it again, what it is.
But you don't want to create a pool where everybody all of a sudden says, oh, well, they approved 200,000 last year.
So let's go spend it.
So let's put this, that, and the next thing in there. I don't want it to be.
In some ways, you're better off than not even have one.
And for everybody to spend it, you know? I mean, that's just foolish. You know, the idea is to build a fund so when there's a need there, we've got to get the proper mindset. We've got to eliminate this baloney about wants. There's a difference between wants and needs, and I think the town really needs to focus on that. When you need something, fine, you know, like the school roof was a need, but there's been several other things that have come through this town where it's been more of a want than a need. And I think we have to clarify that. So, you know, the stabilization fund, I would like to see, make sure that that requires 2/3 vote to get that money out of
it. It does. It does.
And that way you have a nice check and balance, and hopefully more people in town will get a vested interest in this and be able to determine what's really needed for the town and eliminate some of the wants. Because I would hate to see that money set aside and every department come in with a wish list of wants and not the needs. And that's what I'd like to.
And I agree, Jeff, because if we don't have, each department doesn't have a good 5-year capital plan.
Correct.
It's gonna be fluctuating on how much money is available.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's up to the Capital Improvement Committee.
I understand
and the
that.
Capital Improvement Committee right now is starting to work on a legit 5-year capital improvement plan
so
mm-hmm. for all
if
departments.
A department has a vehicle they need in 19 because there's an excess fund in 18, they're not going to move to 18.
Why not? The ambulance did it.
We're trying to avoid that. Yeah.
I know that. Yeah. I just want to point that out. Right. I don't want you to forget that.
No. That's not forgotten.
Until a few years ago, that was the way the Capital Improvement Committee worked.
I understand.
You can talk with Tom, who chaired that committee until a year or so ago, and he chaired it from the time it was created and whatever the hell it was.
Yep.
And we did, in fact, have, you know, put in budget. And I can remember being on that when David Nixon was here. So that goes back 10 years, at least.
I have no problem setting up a stabilization fund for capital improvements. Mm-hmm. But I think if we put in X amount of dollars, there should, at the end of that fiscal year, we should have money left.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I mean, that would, well, you and can always have money left by putting more money into it, but. I understand, but it will. So if we put money in this year, is that what we will use to fund capital projects?
We might have $400,000 in next year, but what we have established is $250,000. You don't have to go for it next year.
Well, we will have to go for it next year to put back into the
plus the two.
What I see the benefits of it is that it kind of levels things out a little bit, and it does when you have a large purchase that you need to make. And I don't know what that would be, but when you have
whatever it may be,
one would hope that you would tend to build up money. If you're putting
in, I agree,
$250,000, you're only spending $150,000.
We've
done a lot of that.
Right. That would be my.
And a couple of years ago, I don't know when it was. When were you here in the fall? That the selectmen went through and it was like a. We got the figures for free cash, and it was like, look, we got all this free cash, and we spent $700,000 in the fall.
Yeah, in a special.
In a special town meeting, and it's. Mm-hmm.
That was a candy
all
store.
The departments came forward.
Yeah, it was like, oh, look, the piggy bank is out there. Let's
it's
grab
broken.
Some money.
Let's get it.
Well, we had some of your office.
But, you know, and we've managed to push back at the, so that that's not happening these days.
Right,
we're not
just at annual.
Mm-hmm. Well, just by not having it as a special, it's a step in the right direction. We shouldn't be spending capital at a special.
I agree. And there, I mean, there obviously will be a situation where we don't have a choice, but, you know, it's...
Yeah.
If there is a choice, then...
Well, would the Capital Improvements Committee have some input on this?
They should.
I hope so. You're meeting next...
No.
Whoever...
Too many.
Well, you're on it, but...
Jeffrey's listening.
Okay. John, you and John are on it in the Capital Improvement Committee. We would have done, we would actually talked about it tonight, but John's not, was not available, so...
Right, okay.
So the intent was to have the Capital Improvement Committee present the capital article so that we can...
And that'll be next week anyway.
Next week, yeah.
Okay. Then we'll discuss stabilization.
And we'll discuss stabilization funding.
But you already voted to create one, correct?
No.
No.
So we have to create it and fund it?
Well, the town has to create it.
Got to create it and then fund it.
It's just an article.
Right. And that does need two-thirds?
I believe it does take two-thirds, it takes two-thirds to take it out. I think it takes two-thirds to put it in, but I'm not sure.
I don't think so.
I don't think so.
I think it's 50.
Okay, well, we have to find out.
I mean, the general, what I believe was two-thirds, but they've changed the municipal modernization a little bit, they've changed some of those things. So I have it. I had it on the warrant, I think, for the whole town meeting.
Anything else we need to talk about? We've 2 hours and 10 minutes, so we're 10 minutes beyond...
Make a motion, we adjourn.
...the watching hour. Is a motion to adjourn, is there a second?
I'll second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
It's unanimous. Thank you.